Welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. Joining me now is Brandon Macdonald, the CEO of Fireweed Zinc. And Brandon, good to have you back. How are you?
Yeah, I'm doing well. Thanks.
Good. Really interesting announcement today. You've acquired two parcels of land and in very different parts, but around your project. So let's start with the very first one. And this is sort of a western extension of the boundary zone. Tell me about this particular area and this land package.
Yeah, I mean, you know, there's two, like I said, two deals we did. Both have a part of the deal that's land to the west of boundary zone. You know, what we saw there is, you know, we've talked about the fertile corridor, which traces the Hess fault from Jason to end zone to boundary zone to the 11 anomaly. And that trend continues off our property and into this new ground. And, you know, it was critical that first the 11 anomaly ran off the ground to the west onto this ground. So it was important for us to lock that extension up. The Imperial anomaly, which was previously identified by Kaminco, spanned actually the ground we got from Questex and from the two individuals. So this was, you know, critical to acquire those. And then what we saw was, you know, as we've done more and more work in this district, the search area for mineralization has really expanded. And what was previously written off, we now realize was probably written off prematurely. So locking up the rest of this corridor and having access to this massive data set, you know, really gives us a head start in looking at this ground.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about the data set specifically, because we're talking about 318 kilometers in one and 74 kilometers in the other. So it's a very large area and gives you a tremendous amount of area within the company now. But how important will that data set to be where you want to start looking? Or do you kind of have an idea of extending where you are right now? Or are there other areas that you're going to look at as well?
Yeah, you know, so this area had a lot of work done on it. This was part of a joint venture, you know, ages ago, 2011, 2012. They were looking for Carlinsdale gold mineralization, and they spent $10 or $20 million on the project. A lot of high quality geochem, a lot of geophysics. They did some drilling, did a whole bunch of mapping. And this is all data that's going to be highly valuable to us. So the nice thing is, you know, our acquisition price really came in for a pennies on the dollar for what the data would have cost to gather ourselves.
Okay. And how do you now go about taking a look at it? Will you do any work at all this year? Is this for next year or down the road? How do you sort of look at a package like this?
Well, first thing we have to do is go through all the data, right? So, you know, you'll see in this news release, we've got maps, but this is not in-depth investigation. There's a lot to do. So first thing is to understand, reinterpret the geochemistry, level the geochemistry versus the samples we've taken. You know, take a look at the geophysics, integrate their geophysics data set with ours. Try to understand where those intersections of structure and geochemistry, you know, what that might mean. There's a lot to do before next summer. And then going into next summer, I think we'll definitely get out on the ground. You know, the nice thing is we don't have to go out there and lay down, you know, the first set of soil samples or anything like that. That's done for us. So we're going to have to go out there and look at it, you know, with a different eye than what they did. They were looking for something very specific that's very different than what we're looking for. So, you know, they would have could potentially literally have walked over something that we would have found extremely interesting. So we have to get that out there and set foot on the ground, maybe follow up with some gravity, which is particularly useful for the style of mineralization that we look for. If it wasn't something they were using. And then, you know, potentially in the years coming, if some of the targets, you know, prove interesting enough, do some drilling.
Absolutely. It sounds exciting. Anyway, we look forward to hearing about that in 2021. Brandon, great to see you again. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
All right. Brandon Macdonald, the CEO of Fireweed Zinc.